Hello everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is André Kröger from Dagobi. Today I would like to show you how to draw this flower frame with vector watercolor brushes. Please create a new document, go to File and click New. And I use 340mm by 210mm and I use color mode RGB. In this tutorial, I'm going to draw with watercolor brushes. I'm going to use my own watercolor brushes, and all these brushes are available on my website, dagobi.com, and you will find links in the description. So I start with some of these brushes. So scroll down and start with this brush, and I'm going to change the stroke color. So I like to draw with red color, for example this color, and choose a paintbrush tool, make a double click on it, and I'm going to use this position, click OK. So try this brush, so that's fine, and I like to apply a width profile, so go to the toolbar, you're on top, and going to use this first width profile. All these profiles are default width profiles from Illustrator, and so change the color a little bit. So that's fine, delete this, and I start with the drawing. So next I'd like to pick another brush and like to draw with the same width profile. So if you choose another brush, Illustrator change automatically the width profile to default. So, but I'd like to draw with the same width profile, so select this line. And Illustrator changes width profile from this line. And if you like to draw with the same width profile, so first deselect, hold the control key and click on your artboard. And now it's very important, hold the alt key and pick another brush to get to use the same width profile. So next, I'd like to change the blending mode. So select both lines and change, open the transparency panel and change the blending mode to darken. So if you like, you can change the stroke white a little bit, hold down the control key and click on the small arrows. Change the width in very small steps. So deselect, hold the control key and click on your artboard. And now pick another brush and hold the alt key to get the same, to use the same width profile. So if you like to move this line, hold the control key, click and drag your mouse. And now again, hold the alt key and click, pick a new brush. So that's fine. Next, I'd like to draw with green color. So change the stroke color to green and draw a line. So that's fine. So, but this time I'd like to draw with another width profile. I'm going to create my own width profile. So I recommend you to draw a line. choose the line segment tool, hold the shift key and draw a line. So change the stroke width to very big, so 40 points, and now choose the width tool and go to the line, click and drag, and now go to the start. And to the end. And I'd like to move this point. So I'm going to change the color, the layer color, make a double click on the layer and change it to magenta. So that's fine. And now I'm going to apply this width profile to the width profile panel. So click on this button, add to profiles. And so now you will find a new width profile here. So you can delete this leaf. Now choose again the paintbrush tool, and this time I'm going to use another brushes. So for example, this brush. So, and like to apply the new width profile to this brush. So select the line and choose your new width profile. So you can change the stroke width. So I like it, and I start with the leaves. And again, change the blending mode to darken. So deselect. And now choose another brush, hold the Alt key and click pick a new brush. Hold the Control key to move the line. And I'd like to change the stroke width. So that's fine. Now I'd like to get the same red color and the width profile. So hold the Control key and select one of these lines. So now we have this, the width profile and the red color, the red stroke color. So now deselect, and I continue with these brushes and the width profile. Hold the Alt key, choose a brush, and now change the blending mode to multiply. And change the stroke width. And now I'd like to draw with green color, with the same green color. So select one of these green lines. Now deselect and continue with green color. And change the blending mode again to multiply. So next, change the color to yellow and pick a brush and draw with the blending mode multiply. So that's fine. So next I'm going to create a pattern brush and I choose the ellipse tool and create a circle. So hold the shift key for a perfect circle. And now change the color, none color for stroke and black color, black fill color. And now go to the brushes panel and click on this button, new brush. And choose pattern brush. So, and change the spacing. So, I think 60%. That's fine. And change the colorization method to tints. So, delete the circle. And now create a new circle. And change again the color, none fill color, and choose green color for stroke, and choose your new pattern brush, and change the stroke white. So if you like, you can change the spacing. So I recommend you to hide the edges, go to view and hide edges. Can use the shortcut. Make a double click on the pattern brush. Click here and you can use your wheel to change. So that's fine. So, and I'm going to change the blending mode to darken. And change the color. So, if you like to change the color, all three sliders together, hold the control key and click on the sliders, and you can change the color. So, that's fine. Now I'm going to make a copy of the circle. So drag this layer down to the new layers button to copy the layer. Now select the layer and scale it a little bit. So I hold Control and the Shift key. And now move this down. And change the stroke white 0.5 and change the color to red. And I like to scale both circles, so hold the control key and select the second circle. Now choose the selection tool, hold the shift key, So next I'm going to move the whole group down, so select the whole group and use the shift key and the arrows on your keyboard. So next choose line tool, line segment tool, and draw a line and hold the shift key for vertical line and apply the new pattern brush. Change the stroke width. And I'm going to change the stroke color to gray. So next, I'd like to delete line here in the middle. So choose the eraser tool and select the line and erase. So next, choose the group selection tool and select this line and change the stroke width. So now choose the direct selection tool, select this anchor point and move it up. Okay, that's fine. And now I'm going to draw with the same leaf brushes and color. So choose the paintbrush tool and now select green line. And this time change the stroke width to very small. Now deselect, hold the control key and click on your artboard and change the stroke width. So that's fine. So you can draw with the same brushes, and if you like to apply another brush to these strokes, so select one of these lines, now hold the Alt key and pick another brush to get the same color and the same width profile. So hold the Alt key and click one of these brushes. So that's fine. And now I'd like to draw some leaves here on this position. So next, like to draw with this red color. So to get this color, hold the control key and click on the red line. And now choose another brush and change the stroke width. So next I'd like to draw a flower. So this time I'm going to use don't use a wood profile. So with red color, choose some of these brushes. That's fine. And second brush. So select all three lines and rotate it a little bit. And now with green color, and next change the blending mode to multiply. So select the flower and move this flower down. I'm going to scale. So it's very important to check the scale options. So open the transparency panel. The transform panel, and go to the panel options and enable scale, strokes and effects. So that's fine. So next I'd like to delete some of the small circles. And before I do that, I'm going to expand the circles and the line. So select one circle, hold the shift key to select the other lines. And now go to object and click on expand appearance. So now we have many circles. And now choose the group selection tool and click one circle, hold the shift key to select more circles. So if you like, you can scale some of the circles. Select circle, choose the selection tool, hold shift and alt key. So next, with the selection tool, select the green object. And now choose the eraser tool. So I'd like to go to view and choose hide edges. And now I'd like to delete circles here. So next, choose the selection tool and select red circles. Now again with the eraser tool. So and last, I'd like to draw some red leaves. So select one of these red leaves. Now change the tool, choose a paintbrush tool and draw some red leaves. That's it, I'm done. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.